Hi, hello everybody. My name is Riccardo Sai. I'm a creative producer and personal branding photographer. I'm here with Kerry Ellis. So Kerry, who are you and what do you do?
Hi, I'm Kerry. I'm an image consultant and stylist. I help people with their wardrobes. So I help them to portray their brand in the way that they show up in terms of what they wear. I've been doing this for about 15 years now and I absolutely love it. So I'm kind of in a similar world to you, really, because we kind of think about people's visibility and how they come across and, you know, whether it's you with photos or camera, or whether it's me in terms of, you know, down, you know, videos and things like this, or whether it's in person. It's the same sort of thing, really, isn't it? So we're in similar businesses, I would say.
Absolutely, yeah. We when we met, we started to talk about a very interesting concept, which I absolutely loved, you know, and it's something that you mentioned. Dressing your personal brand, you know, so and it was interesting because, of course, you know, you were talking about your job, you know, and but I just thought there were a lot of similarities actually to what I do, you know. So tell me more about, you know, what do you mean with the dressing your personal brand?
Yes, so we all have a personal brand. I think everybody recognises that term these days, don't they? And it's just how you come across to people, what your reputation is. And I kind of think of it in terms of how you look, sound and behave. And I focus on the look part of that, as I guess you do too in your business, in terms of, you know, what people see when they meet you, and very much what you wear tells people about you. So it communicates your personal brand. So I talk about how you dress your personal brand, so how you appeal to the sorts of people you want to appeal to, how you come across to them, but by using your clothes to sort of communicate that. So me personally, I'm very colourful and things, so I'm always wearing colour, for example, so you very rarely see me in black or anything like that, because it's part of my brand to be quite colourful, stylish. So I might have pussy boobs on today because it's quite current, that kind of thing. So it's about thinking about you as a person and your personal brand, how you come across, and then how you can communicate that through what you wear. And I guess you do very similarly in terms of how you come across then, either in a photograph or, you know, in a video.
Yeah. No, that's very interesting. Because you, I've been thinking about, you know, how do I need to dress, you know, for this chat that we're having on Zoom, you know, and it really made me think that a lot of time, you know, because I'm working in studios and on location, I like to wear something quite comfortable, you know. For me, it's very important, you know, and I like to have different layers, because I know that especially if you're working on studio, it can be really, really hot under the lights. And even if you're shooting on location, I mean, you never know, you know, English weather is so unpredictable. So I want to make sure that I've got
sure.
different layers, you know, like, so yeah, that's very interesting, you know, but it's a...
Yeah, I was gonna say, it's really interesting because feeling comfortable, we all want to feel comfortable, because when you don't feel comfortable, actually you don't come across as yourself, because you might be holding yourself very stiff, or you might be completely opposite, you might be really slovenly. So absolutely, comfort has got to be one of the key things, and confidence is the other thing I talk about. So feeling confident in your clothes, so if it's not you to be trussed up in a suit and all the rest of it, and actually for you that wouldn't work in terms of your personal brand, then don't do it. So it needs to be comfortable, but yeah, it needs to be confident. And then it needs to sort of sell yourself as who you are, being really real. This is not about fake news. This is about being you. So the fact that you've put a colourful top on today, I would say as a photographer or a videographer, I'd expect somebody like you to be quite creative. And so wearing a bit of colour now and again might be exactly what you want to do, because that's part of your brand. So that's kind of how I approach it, is working out, you know, what someone's personal brand is, who they really are, and how they like to dress. We all have kind of I talk about style personality, but we all have likes and dislikes in terms of the way you like to dress. And if yours is feeling comfortable, absolutely, we need to feel comfortable in our clothes. It's so important. And yours is practical as well. You've got to be, you know, like you say, you could be running around or getting hot and need to bend down and move, and I don't know, you're looking up at people at funny angles and all sorts of things, aren't you? So your wardrobe has to work as hard as you work. That's what I always say to people. It's got to work, you know, for you, and also for what you do for a living and your personal brand.
Absolutely, yeah. You also mentioned like a word that I'm really passionate about, which is authenticity. To me, yeah. It really resonates, you know, because I mean, at least, you know, when I'm working as a photographer, but also when I'm working in films, you know, I'm always looking, you know, to my mission is to really kind of bring out the unique personality that the people have, you know, the story. We all have a story. Our story can change, you know, over the years. And we want to kind of rebrand ourselves. We want to tell a new stories. And it's so important, you know, like to find that story. And I find that my role as a and especially as a photographer, is to really kind of help people, you know, to bring out that unique, special, and amazing story that, that people have. And it's a very interesting process because sometimes it's difficult, you know, because people, they're not perhaps fully aware of who they are, you know. And I think, what do you think about that? You know, how our job is also kind of facilitating that in a way. What do you think?
Yeah, no, absolutely. I mean, one of the first things I sort of do with people is think about, you know, who they are, what they, how they spend their life, you know, what do they work, do they not work, do they have, what sort of work do they do, who are they inside, who are they really inside, and how do they kind of want to come across to people. And it is about being real and authentic and not being fake. So this isn't about, you know, in my world, it's not about dressing up all the time just because you think you should do that. You can very much embrace yourself and your style in what you choose to wear. So, you know, I have clients who, so I had a guy the other day actually who is quite sort of conservative, I would say, quite classic in his styling. There's no point me then suggesting to him that he wears some bright royal blue, I don't know, shirt or something, because it's not him and he's going to feel so conspicuous and things. It's not his brand, it's not who he is. So I'm 100% about it being about the person and dressing for them, and then also thinking about their personal brand. So if we are talking about people that are in business or working, then it's, you know, how do you want to come across to people, and how can we use those sort of, I usually get people to come up with adjectives to describe themselves, but how can we use those words then and reflect those in the what you choose to wear and therefore how you come across. So it's similar to yours, it's telling your story. In my case, it's by the clothes you choose to wear. I mean, you can think of examples of people who, well, an example I was thinking of the other day, if you go in to see somebody and they look a bit sort of, you know, fuddy-duddy behind the times, and you're expecting somebody innovative and creative and with it, it kind of makes you think twice because it's not congruent with what you're expecting. So there's kind of that as well. There's like an expectations layer on top of things as well. So it's just being mindful of all those things and putting it all together. And then I like to make it easy for people. So in my world, I then would suggest things like a capsule wardrobe, for example, which is just putting together a few pieces of clothing that all mix and match, so that when you open your wardrobe in the morning, you go to it and you know that pretty much everything that's in there goes with everything else, and you can easily put together that wardrobe that feels like you, being real you, authentic you, and comes across in the way you want to come across. And I guess when you're styling people, when you're asking people to do videos or photographs, do you ask them to think about, you know, how they're coming across in that same way, I guess?
Yeah, I think it's I think it's interesting what you're saying about feeling comfortable with it, with the way we are. I think it's such an important aspect. I think, you know, because if you're comfortable with yourself, you know, I mean, suddenly you become a magnet, you know, and you become much more confident about who you are and what you want. And I think I'm thinking about, you know, people who need like business portraits. It's so important, you know, just to really kind of feel comfortable in their own skin, you know. And in a way, I think my job, you know, I mean, your job is of course, you know, just helping them to find the right outfit, you know. But I think is in also kind of helping them to find the image that they want to get across, you know. Yeah. My job is very similar, you know. I'm just using similar tools, you know. Well, actually different tools. Yeah. I'm using lenses, I'm using locations. I mean, I love working on location, and it's very, it's just, you know, using different colors, you know, different textures, grain, adding grain to the photos, you know, and all that, you know, to really kind of bring out that incredible personality that people have, you know. And it's a very fascinating journey. I really like that, you know. And it's different, you know, because with film, you know, you're working with images and sound as well, you know. So it's
of course
as well, you know, with images, with photos, yeah. It's different, you know, because you have one less tool, you know, which is, you don't have music, you don't have audio, you know, so it's so you have to communicate more at a subliminal level, you know, I mean, your brand, your story, you know. So
but in these days where there's so much on social media, isn't there, and we are taught to sort of, you know, think about our digital footprint and everything, so even those still images that you're talking about, they stay with us forever, don't they? So, you know, making sure that you've thought about what that still image is going to look like, and, you know, in terms of the way you dress, but also everything else that sits behind it. So for you, it's like the location as well. So, you know, what kind of business are you in? Who are you trying to attract? So therefore, where do you want those photographs taken? Or if it's video, where are you going to, you know, do the video? All makes, it all sort of like adds layers, I think, to someone's personal brand and therefore how they come across to other people. I think we both probably do very similar things, albeit, like you say, with different tools. I use clothes and you use screens and images and lenses and things like that. But to help somebody to sort of come across to be the best version of them and to tell their own story in that kind of way. I just think that, you know, people have their own kind of signature style I talk about, but it's them being them, really. And then what you're doing is showing that in many images, and then collectively we're sort of helping people to put that across on social media, or just in terms of, you know, when they dress, in terms of when they meet people. But there's so much of it out there now, isn't it? So you almost can't avoid thinking about it these days, I would say. It's sort of like a necessary thing to think about how you're coming across on various different channels, etc. And images are just so powerful, and they do say a picture tells 1,000 words, don't they? So I'm sure you probably use that one yourself.
I agree. No, that's very fascinating. I think it's and at the end of the day, you know, we are there to communicate someone's brand through images. And at the end of the day, you know, so you are working with images and I'm working with images, you know, so that's why our jobs somehow, they are very complementary. And so I see that as a holistic approach, really, you know, just to really kind of curating the image and the brand, you know, in a very kind of holistic and kind of a 360 degrees type of approach, you know, which I think is what you're doing and what I do and what I do. And I think is a, that's why, you know, I think it is, if you can, you know, work with a team like us, you know, I think it's great, you know, because that means that you can really get the best out of this collaboration, creative collaboration. So, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. I think people are kind of looking for help these days. And I'm sure you're the same. I love helping people just to be them, but to feel confident and to project the image they want to project, you know, so you've got this opportunity. And in my case, you know, I always think, you know, we get dressed every single day. Every single day, the first thing you do usually is get up and get dressed. And if you can start the day with that real positive mindset, putting something on that makes you feel, you know, positive in yourself, feel confident, how brilliant is that? Rather than start the day feeling a bit ugh because you haven't got the clothes you want in your wardrobe, or you don't feel like you, or they don't feel comfortable, or whatever it might be. And then being able to sort of meet people during the day, or in your case, you know, through video and through photographs and things like that, but so that people get you, they properly understand who you are, and you know, you come across in the way that you really want to. That's the bit I love, and getting the emails from people afterwards that say that's helped is fantastic. I love it.
It's, I find also what I like about personal branding photography is really that it's a very transformative process.
Yeah.
Go through a collaboration with me, you know, and at the end, you know, they're quite different, you know. So we develop a bond, you know, because, you know, it's about trust, you know, with the photography in this case. And I think, you know, at the end, you know, you both evolve somehow, you know. And I realize that, you know, a lot of time, you know, I create very, you know, friendships, you know, and very
100%
collaborations, you know. And I think it's so amazing, you know. And as you said, you know, it's about helping people, you know. And when people can really feel that you're helping them, you know, and you're really there, you know, soul and body, you know, and you're totally committed to helping them, it's such an amazing feeling. And I think at the end, you know, what is a part of their process, you know, it will result in a nice image, you know, and also in an image of yourself that you're proud of, you know. And and a lot of times, if it happened to you, it's so incredible that it's you know, the camera, it's almost like a mirror, you know. That's what I find very fascinating about my work, you know. You're really kind of showing this mirror in front of a person, and you, of course, you know, my job is to position this mirror, you know, so that, you know, I can facilitate that in a way, but I think it's very fascinating, you know, because then when people look at this mirror after the post production, after the shooting of the photos, they're always a bit surprised, you know. They're like, oh, okay, I didn't realize that, you know. So
isn't that lovely? Yeah,
an element of surprise, you know, which I think is so rewarding, isn't it? So.
Well, it's that positivity, isn't it? So it's exactly the same for me. If I've helped someone, you know, either even just shown them their colours that suit them, things like that can make such a difference. But if I'm someone's wardrobe and I'm able to put outfits together for them, and they try them on and I take photographs and then I'll send them to them afterwards, pretty much like you do, my photographs are nothing like yours, obviously. Mine are just quick snaps for them as a ready reminder kind of thing. Yeah. But they can then see the difference between one outfit and another outfit and how they felt in it as well. And it kind of just brings all of that back. So yeah, that whole positivity of almost like the before and after, isn't it? So it's, you know, you can help somebody and you can sort of move them along and help them tweak their image and feel good about themselves. And we've all got so much to feel good about. It's not, I mean, in my case, you know, people say about size and all the rest of it. It's nothing to do with your shape or your size. It's all about knowing yourself and how you want to come across to other people. And then it's tips and tricks that I would use to help people to look their best. And the same for you. You'll give people tips as to how to look the best down the camera or on a photograph or on a video or whatever. And it's just that help. But like you, I've got friends. I've been doing it for 15 years now, and I've got friends, genuine friends who are clients, who, yeah, I've got to know really, really well. And they kind of, I don't know, let you into their lives, don't they? Because you get to know somebody really well. And it's absolutely, I mean, that's what I love, really, to be honest with you, just to know that you've made a difference and it's a positive difference out there. That's what, you know, makes me smile every day, just to know that people are feeling good about me.
I think on this note, I think we should probably wrap up, you know, but it's, really, really, thank you for your time, Kerry. I really enjoy kind of sharing, you know, our vision of our job, you know, and how we can really help people, you know, to really make a difference on their lives, you know. So thank you so much.
Yeah, well, thank you for inviting me along. It's been great. Thank you, Riccardo.
Okay. Bye-bye. Thank you, Kerry.
Bye. Take care. Bye.
All right.